Crossroads Sci-Fighters is I Super Sci-Fighter, and today I'm doing a list of my top 5 favorite Ben 10 cartoons. So let's get started.
Number 5. Number 5, the Ben 10 reboot. Okay, well, the reason this is my least favorite of the bunch is, well, I don't know, it's a bit too goofy for me. Don't get me wrong, I bought the
watch.
Yeah, see?
But this isn't what I wanted!
Well, as I was saying, I did buy the toys for this reboot, and yeah, they're pretty cool, and I do like how many of the different aliens are in here. I do like that they do try to do something
new.
You
didn't bring a costume.
Drink it in, bad boys.
Yeah, Forearms looks pretty neat here. Okay, I do actually like how they redesigned Wildvine and Stinkfly, but I'm not a big fan on Upgrade's redesign. Okay, give me a minute. Okay, as I was saying, yeah, this brings up a good point. I do like how they included characters such as Wrath and Humongousaur. Sorry about all the buffering. I have a really sucky PS4 with a really sucky internet. This is the only way I can get these things into this video. Anyway, yeah, as I was saying earlier, I do like this redesign for Stinkfly here. Makes him look more heroic and less, well, like an ugly bug. Don't get me wrong, even though I used to be afraid of bugs back in the day, still slightly am, but for some reason, funny enough, Stinkfly never freaked me out as a kid. But I like this newer Stinkfly better, since he does look more like, you know, someone you would want to save you in a crisis, rather than something that would crawl out of someone's nightmare. Come on, you stupid hunk of junk. Okay, yep, and here's Humongousaur. One of my favorite additions to this reboot. Heat Blast is my favorite alien of all time, but I do like how they're bringing in some nostalgia for the Alien Force / Ultimate Aliens fans. The things I don't really like about it, though, is, you know, all the, it's kind of like the Teen Titans Go of all the Ben 10s. Well, I guess that does it for number 5. Ben 10 reboot, number 5. Next. Okay, number 4, Ben 10 Omniverse.
Yes! Thanks for the help, man, but I got this now.
I was about to say, I think this one does a bit better of a job taking itself seriously than the reboot, but yeah, when I saw the trailers and saw this thing in it, I was like, this is gonna be stupid. This is not gonna work. But surprisingly, I ended up liking it. So,
you hear me? Forearms. I don't want gray matter. I don't want nanomech. Forearms.
So, yeah, this show was the last time they ever actually continued a canon, and then the reboot was like, yeah, we're starting to over. It's got some pretty cool new aliens in. Anything but one of my electric guys, please. And immediately electric guy. Yep. Shark Squatch, pretty cool character.
For Pete's sake, give me a break, what are you? Can I pick him or what?
Okay, yeah, here's another stupid alien that I didn't really like. Ball Weevil. You kidding me? Okay, well, I mean, they can't all be winners, but, I mean, still, this show kind of won me over.
There. Now the real Ben looks like somebody else.
Yeah. Funny enough, even though I still had a bit of a bug phobia back when this show was a thing. Crash Opera also didn't really freak me out, but I know he's still not up there on the favorite ones. Ah, Kickin' Hop. Yeah, that's a pretty good one. Yeah, this show is pretty good. Better than Reboot, but not better than the next few. So, yeah, that's number 4 for you guys. Benton Omniverse. Number 3, Benton Alien Force.
No, Ben, you're hurt.
I already lost you once. Not gonna let that happen again.
Yeah. Okay. When I first saw this guy, I like, that's my favorite one from this series. When I first saw this alien transformation, it gave me the same feeling of, whoa, this kid's cool, he's my favorite one from the show, that I had with Heat Blast in the original show.
Please, Quantum Aramaphore.
This is my magnetic personality.
I mean, this one had plenty of cool aliens. It had an awesome animation style. The theme song was a little bit lacking because it didn't have any words.
Humongousaur! Humongousaur?
That function is not available. Omnitrix must return to Primus.
What's that all about, Tennyson? I don't know. It's never happened before. Where are all my aliens?
That function is not available.
The humor in this was much better than...
Somebody named Primus is
doing that? The reboot humor.
I'm a little out of practice.
It's Azmuth.
You should have known. The Omnitrix kept saying it was looking for its creator.
Yep, Vilgax, cool villain. Azmuth, pretty neat. This show, it's just pretty good, but still not my favorite of all the Ben 10 shows. It's right in the middle. I guess when I... I will admit, I kind of found it cool every time Ben would yell the name of his alien, like, Swampfire, Humongousaur, yada yada.
Let me tell you something, Phil.
And Raph, yep, this is where he first appeared, and he's awesome.
Defeat you. Azmuth will hunt you down, even though you're standing right here.
Wrath is the funniest dadgum transformation, because he's always like, you want to go, Gravity? Let's go! He just reminds me of wrestlers like freaking Macho Man Randy Savage or something. You know what gets Wrath to the boiling point? I mean, it's that kind of hilariosity. And he has laser vision.
In at the same time.
Okay, so why'd he turn him into goop?
No!
Okay, I kind of forgot a few of these episodes, but...
The power is unbelievable!
I can do anything!
I mean, it's kinda...
almost anything.
Anyway, what yeah, that's, number three. So,
I can't move!
Off to number two.
I turned off Goop's artificial gravity.
Number two. Ben 10 Ultimate Alien.
Do you have a statement?
Yeah.
It's hero time!
Yeah, what I liked about Ultimate Alien is it really stepped it up ever since Alien Force.
Open it.
One reason being for it stepping it up, if this is the correct thing I'm thinking about here. No, well, yeah. Jet Ray is another one of those cool ones that I like. I say from this show, he'd be my, well, third favorite non-original alien.
He's gone.
Detected. Function not available. Please stand by.
And another thing I really liked about this, they came up with new aliens, like, straight out of the woodwork for nearly every episode.
Oh, now you want to talk.
Chromastone, another neat one. I will admit, though, for Alien Force and Ultimate Aliens, it does kind of feel like a good chunk that they were aliens or somewhat, like, new versions of the original ones. But they're still pretty darn cool, and I like the little new mixes that they do with them. And, yeah, all the action's good in these two shows. And all the alien powers are cool. Well, that's number two, so, off to the next one. And number one, you most likely saw this coming. It's the original series. And right off the bat, my favorite alien, Heat Blast. Well, do I really need to say much more? Because, I mean, it's the original. Nothing outdoes the original. All the aliens were cool, the theme song was kicky. It was funny, smart, cool, awesome. It was everything a kid's show needs to be. Especially if it's a superhero kid's show. Everything in here is cool. Every alien transformation, every name, every character. Accelerate, my second favorite alien. Just, I mean, this is my favorite, one of my favorite shows as a kid. And it still is. Yeah, I mean, it outdoes the rest just because it's the original. And that, you know, it got everything it needed to right on its first and only shot. So, yeah, that's my top five. Favorite Ben 10 cartoons. If you agree with my list, put it down in the comments below. If you don't, I'd still like to hear what your opinion on it is. Like, what kind of order would you put yours in? So, yeah, that's, I'll just let the rest of these transformations play out, and then I'll end the video. I think that's gonna do it for now. See you dudes in the next one.